Hello, my name is Andrea and I am from AndieStashed. That's my YouTube channel and I'm here to show you some yarn acquisitions and other things I got from Etsy. I completely forgot that the Bay Area Yarn Crawl was a couple weeks ago and I went to three different stores in San Francisco and I didn't get a whole lot of yarn. I got a little bit of yarn, but I just wanted to show you what I got. And I ordered, again, a couple things from Etsy. So, the first store I went to was ImaginKnit. It's in a cute neighborhood. I love that store. And I got this giant, look at this giant hank of yarn. It is by Atelier Yarns. The color is grayish. Super fine alpaca, made in Peru. Grown in the Andes. They say to use a size 6 needle, which I don't know. Like, what do you think? I think a size 6 is going to be a little thin. Let's see if I can get my finger under there. No, that's 2. Whoops. Let's see if I can get 1. There we go. So let's see how many yards. Whoops, I keep turning the camera around. 660 yards or 603 meters, 227 grams. This is a lot. It says you should get 5.5 stitches to the inch, which I think that's a little generous. I think I'm going to get more like 6 or 6.5, because this does feel like, it doesn't feel like a DK weight. It feels kind of like a sport weight to me. It feels a little bit bigger than a fingering, but I got 2 of them. And I really want to make the Oba sweater by AndieStashed. And I think I want to use a cream color to go with it. And I just think it'll be so beautiful. I would really like that. So I'm going to put that over here on my table. So let's see. And then I'm going to attempt to make socks again. So I tried almost a year ago, and the yarn got so stretched out. And I tried to put them on my husband's foot, and I don't know what was going on. But I tried again. I got Cascade Heritage Sock, Superwash Merino. 75% superwash merino, superwash merino wool, 25% nylon. So I think these will go really well together. And then I got Rowan Kid Silk Haze. I've been seeing these around, and every time I see them around, I pick one up. I really want to do petite knits fortune sweater out of this. I think it'll be really beautiful. I'm a little nervous about making a sweater that only has mohair. I've never done that before. I've always held mohair with something else, but get a little outside my comfort zone. So now we have my Etsy acquisitions, and I buy these from a woman named WineMakerSister. I'm actually going to pull these things down here to the dining table so I could sit and show you. Sorry. There we go. Yes, I got these stitch markers. Aren't they cute? They have like little flowers on them. These are like porcelain, like real porcelain. And I have a friend who's she does pottery, and she commented on these. She's like, oh my God, these are real porcelain. Like somebody made these, and I don't know if she made them herself, but it's hard to find the right focus. And then there's a red one and a black one. Oops. So there's that. Also, the bag that she sent, this little tote, little drawstring tote, has this stitch marker on it that says thank you. And then I bought the cutest, most sweetest tea set. So it was like around, I think this was around $30. And it came with the whole tea set. So I have 6 teacups. And this is also real porcelain. And then I have a sugar bowl. And at first I was a little worried about these being stitch markers on a project and the project getting jostled around and stuff like that, especially in a project bag. But I think I'm only going to use them on like really special things. And then I have a teapot. And the teapot is on my Ketton cardigan. If you saw my last YouTube episode, you would have saw that I'm working on this. So I have the teapot right here on the Ketton cardigan, and it's marking the front side of it. That's how I know it's the front, because it's like over here in this corner. And this is the brioche. This is the collar. Let's see. Should I try it on? So this is what it's going to be like. It's going to zip up here, and these stitches are going to grow definitely, but this is the color. And so it's ready for the next phase of shaping. That's the point that I'm at. So that's been about it. That was my yarn acquisitions from the Bay Area Yarn Crawl, and my stitch marker acquisitions from WineMakerSister. And last thing I'm going to show you is I got some cashmere from Colourmart, my favorite place. And I really want to make the Gambier cardigan. I think that's it. I don't know the yarn, I mean the designer's full name. I know her name is Lindsay. I'm not sure of her last name. But the yarn is going to be a chunky weight beige. And then it has all this like color work motifs in it. And so I think I'm going to use this purple. And this purple is like tweedy, has like tweedy flecks and nubs in it. I'm going to use some of this. And even though this is cashmere, it's not fluffy like cashmere. It needs to be washed. I have to wash this before I knit with it. It has like a lot of spinning oil on it, and it feels like a little bit like rope. And it smells like dust or a factory. It's a really strong smell. So I'm going to use the purple, and I'm going to use this gray. You only have to use 2 colors. So that's it. You don't need a lot of your contrasting colors. So I hope this is enough to get me by. This set from Colourmart was, I think this was $60 for the cashmere. They said it's a chunky weight. So I think it's going to bloom a lot once it's washed. Aran weight / chunky, so it's not going to be like super bulky or anything, but it'll be bigger than a worsted for sure. They said it's 300 grams. Yep, 300 grams. And then I have this pink, and I don't know what I'll do with the pink, but I'll find something to do with it. So I'm going to put that back up and put that in there. So yeah, I just thought I'd get this little video in while I can. I'm at home alone, so things are quiet, and it's just perfect timing. I can show you around if you like. Get in there. Let's move this stuff over. So this is my, this is the outdoors. This is actually our front door. We have like a little patio furniture, but it's been really rainy, so it's pretty dirty. I don't know if you remember from episode number 4, I think, I mentioned that we just moved and we kind of live in someone's basement. So I'm getting the sunlight. We live in the basement of this big Victorian house. So the landlords live upstairs. There's someone else that's in like a tiny, 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 like really tiny studio apartment right here. I think it's about 200 square feet. Then there's us. There's somebody else that has like a 500 square foot apartment up that way. Let's see if I can show you. Oops. Up that way. So yeah, so this is, that's like our entry, dining area, kitchen. Living room. We've been here since June of last year. We have some built-ins. That's where I have like a lot of my teaching books. Lots of wine, fireplace. Liquor cabinet. All my yarn is in this closet over here. So there's the yarn that's in the bedroom where I have the cones behind me. And then all the other yarn that are like in skeins and hanks are back here. And then separate bedroom that we use. Like kind of like it's my husband's like game room. And then I have my workout mirror there. But yeah, this is our house. So I've been so happy with this house. I really love it. I love living here. We're really close to the downtown. We can walk to restaurants. Yes. Okay. Bedroom. Bedroom. Have random stuff there. This is my yarn wall or yarn shelf. Seating area. I usually sit there. Closet and some storage. Laundry to fold. We have a door here that looks out onto the courtyard. So that was it. Thank you for coming to the channel, visiting. I hope you're having a lovely Sunday. If you're in the southern hemisphere, it's getting a little colder for you, while for us in the northern hemisphere, it's warming up. So spring is definitely here, and I'm pretty excited about it. So thank you again for visiting, and I'll see you soon. I'm glad we can share this knitting time together. Bye-bye.